So dear listeners, I am Dr. Atish Mundra, associate professor with SNJB Srimantraj Dharani College of Pharmacy, Chandwad, Nasik. Would like to discuss with you all regarding documentation and scientific writing. Now, what documentation is all about when you are going for scientific writing? Documentation play an important role because it is the acknowledging sources that we have used during our research work. And let me tell you how this documentation will help a researcher is that it will give a picture or idea to the reader that the researcher has consulted the experts on the subjects and have relied on most current and authoritative sources to support the statement. The first thing is the reader of your paper will understand you have consulted to the experts in the area of that field and you have taken the information from the current and authoritative sources. So your information is foolproof. And another side of the coin is that this documentation will help a researcher to avoid from ethical requirement that you will not fall prey to the plagiarism. So if you are documenting the things of whichever information you are taking help during your research work or during your writing, if you are acknowledging that particular source, then it will be really easy for a researcher to keep oneself away from that plagiarism. I hope everyone must be aware about what plagiarism is, and it really take toll onto researcher if his work is being caught under plagiarism. So today we will be talking about it. What are the different ways of going for scientific writing and what documentation is all about. So let us start with a quote from two gentlemen, George Gopin and Judith Swan. What they said regarding documentation: the fundamental purpose of scientific discourse is not the mere presentation of information and thought, but rather its actual communication. Because it is through that particular information you are talking, you are actually trying to talk or actually trying to communicate with your readers. And that's why it doesn't matter how pleased an author might be to have converted all the right data into the sentences and paragraphs. What matters a lot is whether a large majority of the reading audience accurately perceives what the author had in mind. And this quote, I really found it apt at this point of time, because this happens with most of the researchers. When they start writing their research article or when they are writing their thesis, they may be really pleased ki maine bahut jyada kaam kiya hai, I have done lot of work, I have collected lot of data. But what matters a lot is that whatever data and information which you have gathered by your hard work into the lab, it should be properly put up into proper sentences and paragraphs, because the data and the information which you are putting into your paper or into your thesis, it is not meant for you, it is meant for the public, or it is meant for the reader, that they, after reading your information, they should accurately perceive it and they should be able to understand what exactly author had at the back of his or her mind. So I really observed and found this quote apt at this point of time to start scientific writing presentation. Now, what exactly scientific writing is? It is a hard work which a researcher will have to do. He has to have a clear planning or a clarity at the back of his mind what exactly he wants to do, how he is going to come up with the writing of whatever research has been carried out by him or her. So planning has to be there, how it is going to be written down. There has to have a clarity how many points are to be covered, because during your research work, it may happen that with the same work, you can just break down that work into 2-3 segments and you can get or come up with 2-3 different publications. So that can also be done. For that matter, you should have a clarity and brevity at the back of your mind, exactly how much information you are going to put in into each paper. Let me tell you, when you are going for scientific writing, you should have a simplicity of sentences. Whatever sentences you prepare, they should be as simple as possible, should not be complex one. The word choices which you are making must be apt one, so that, as I said earlier, the information which you are putting in your paper is meant for the readers. So if you try to complicate it, or if you try to make it very scientific in terms of the choices of the words we are using, at that time it becomes very difficult for the reader to understand your paper. And let me tell you, impact factor of any journal or citation of your article will only increase if readers are finding your article interesting. So how you can make your article interesting one, or how you can increase the citation of your work, is by ensuring that your writing has to be very lucid. It has to be very clear. It needs to be very simple. And the choices of words which you are pinning down must be apt enough to convey the message. So revising will come into picture n number of times, and that's why it is shown like a circle, that whenever you are writing, you will be going through first draft, you will be going through second draft, and most of the times revising your draft will be required, because sometimes you start writing the paper in active voice and then you realize that everything I am telling kind of thing will not be accepted. Sometimes you have to write the sentences in passive voices. In revising, you have to be really careful that you are committed enough to writing as a process, because most of the time this has been observed from researchers, that they get fed up with number of drafts and then they just surrender. So it should not happen, and that's why I would say that you should be really committed enough to write a paper and come up with the article. Means you should be determined enough to come up with a research article. Whatever stumbling block may be there into your path, you will come up, you will overcome all those hurdles, and you will come up with the excellent research article. So revising will come into picture n number of times. There will be n number of drafts, but you should not lose your hope, and you should keep revising it. And you will find that at the end of the day, when your article gets published, it is the intellectual joy which no money can buy. So good tech writers requires a lot of practice. And that's why, as a beginner, if you have not published any research paper, then as a beginner, you will find that it is really a troublesome job to do so. But over a period of time, when you will have that skill of putting the things into proper sentences and paragraphs, you will realize that actually paper writing is also a skill, and it one can be skilled into that particular art by practicing. So good tech writers can practice of writing scientific articles, and over a period of time, he or she will realize he or she can easily do it. This picture particularly depicts how you start and what you end up with. You can understand that good writing doesn't happen overnight. It is being said in English that Rome was not built in a day. Similarly, today you have finished your research work and tomorrow you will come up with research article will never happen. You have to start somewhere writing your research findings. Your first draft will be lengthy because you have tried your level best, as we went through that quote, that here you are very pleased that you have done something. It was like a pleasure of hunt. You have come up with the treasure, and that treasure you want to put it into paper. So at that time it will be like, whatever I have done, I will put it into paper, and your first draft will be quite lengthy. Then you will, over a period of time, you will realize that some data or some information which you are putting into that may be redundant, may be repeated, and at that time you are going to cut short it or curtail it down, and you are coming up with the revised draft. When you are submitting that revised draft to the research guide for taking his comments or feedback, he may ask you to reread it and revise it or edit it. So learning and improvement of your research paper, it requires self-review. Sometimes you will realize over a period of time that it is going to be too lengthy, I will have to cut down these particular points. And sometimes you ask your peers or you ask your guides to go through your paper, or even you can send your draft to a subject expert for getting their comment related to your paper. And whatever feedback you are getting from subject expert or your from guide or your peers, then you have to revise or rethink regarding your first draft and come up with the revised draft. Let me tell you, there are no shortcuts practices that will make you perfect in art of writing. There are n number of journals, as I said earlier when we started talking about research methodology, that publishes research papers by just paying 1,000 rupees or 1,500 rupees, but that will never give you the joy of satisfaction that yes, this is the research work which I could publish on my own, and that too in a reputed journal. And right now in today's world, H-index and I-10 index is being considered as a criteria of qualification as a research worker or research scientist. So at that time, your paper will be cited and will be referred to by fellow researcher only when they are finding then there is some substance into your research paper. Whatever you have published, there is some substance and it is valid and verifiable results you have put in into your research paper, then and then only citation for your paper will increase, and then only you will be getting acknowledged as a research scientist by research fraternity all over the world. So writing is going to be a process. The way we have seen, research is also a process, multi-step process, and you have to toil hard for completing your research work. At the same time, once you complete your research work, your research paper writing or thesis writing is also going to be a Herculean task. It is going to be a daunting and frustrating task. But at this point of time, I will say that when you come up with your first research article published into very reputed journal, the intellectual joy which you get after finding your first paper in PDF form, that is something different. You are onto cloud nine like. So I wish that everyone should try to enjoy this intellectual joy of coming up with their own research paper, and that too into a reputed journal. Now, what is documentation? As I said earlier, here in documentation, you are trying to acknowledge all those sources that the researcher has used during his research work. It informs reader why, when you acknowledge sources or research article or research papers of others, it actually informs readers that you have consulted expert on that subject and have relied on the most current and authoritative information which is available into the current stock of knowledge. Another important reason of documentation is it gives proper credit to the sources which we have used in the argument, and it is ethical requirement as well, because failure to do so will lead you into a trouble, because you will be accused of plagiarism. So it is a ethical requirement that whatever information or whatever sources which you use during your research work or while completing your research work, you are supposed to give proper credit to them into your research article. And one more important reason for going with documentation is that it provides readers the books and articles which you have used in support of your argument. As a result, the readers may be encouraged to go to the sources for additional information which is being put up into bibliography. Let me tell you the basic difference between these two terminologies. One is references and second one is bibliography. Is that in references you are taking the information or quotes directly. So whatever information and data or quotes you are taking directly from the articles, that needs to be put up under references. And bibliography or the information which you have referred to but didn't use it directly into your research article, but you feel that unless and until people understand and go through that information, the background regarding my research will not be complete. And that's why I put information regarding those articles or books which I may not have used directly, but indirectly that must have helped me in clearing my concept. At that time, I put information regarding those books and articles under the heading of bibliography. So these are the reasons behind going for documentation. These are the four broad reasons for which one should go for documenting whatever sources are being used by you during your research work. Now, what needs to be documented or what must be documented? There are n number of things which we use into our research work, and out of those, which are those things which needs to be documented? First, very important thing is that any direct quotation, whichever you are using from whichever research article, research paper, book, patent database, whatever you are using and you are taking a direct quotation, may it be a single phrase or a keywords, or must be identified according to the work and the exact place of that particular work. So whenever you are using that from the database, make sure that you need to acknowledge it, you need to document it. Next is any paraphrase or a summary. Any paraphrase or a summary of another individual's written work or from an oral report or presentation, it needs to be documented because you are using that information. Third is any opinion, may it be verbal or in writing. So any opinion without which you could not have reached to your finishing line, or without which you could not have finished your research work. So that kind of information may it be available in form of oral presentation, or may it be available in the form of writing in the research paper. That needs to be documented. Due credit needs to be given to that opinion. Because of that particular opinion, your whole perspective regarding your research work must have changed. So that opinion mattered a lot to you during your research work. So it needs to be documented. Then any statistical data that you have used of others. This data I am not talking about which you have generated on your own. The data which you have collected and taken from someone else's paper, ensure that you give due credit to that researcher whose research data you have taken for putting it into your research article. So any statistical data which have not been compiled by you, which has not been generated by you, needs to be documented properly. Next is any visual that is not being prepared by you. Say for example, I have prepared this visual on my own. So if someone is taking this visual as such and putting it into their presentation, at that time he or she needs to give due credit to me, showing that this particular information is being taken from the presentation of so and so. So any visual which is not being prepared by you needs to be documented properly, and due credit needs to be given to the creator. And any software program that you did not develop on your own, say for example GraphPad Prism you are going to use, say for example Dizzo software you are going to use, or any other software is there, or computer programs are there which you will be using, which has not been developed by you, but it has played an important role while completing of your research work, then at that time that software program needs to be acknowledged, needs to be credited for that matter. Because of that only you could complete your research work properly. Now, what are the components and structure of a research report? A research report is made up of three important parts. One is preliminary material, second one is body, and third one is supplementary material. The most important out of this is the body. body which is going to be the lengthiest part of your research report. Preliminary material is a preliminary material talking about yourself, your research guide, your research organization, and different funding agencies which has helped you during completion of your research work. Whatever research finding you had from your research work needs to be put up under body, and that's why body of research article or research report play a major role in completing your research article or research report. And third important thing or a component of your research report will be your supplementary material. As a university student, let me tell you, you will be required to write a variety of reports for assessment purpose. As I said earlier, you will have to submit a 6-monthly progress report as a requirement for PhD scholars of university. So as a university student, you may be required to submit a variety of reports for assessment purpose. Research report is the one type that is often used in sciences, engineering, and psychology. While submitting your research report, your aim is to write clearly and concisely. This is most important word to be used. You are supposed to write clearly and concisely about your research topic, because it is not your autobiography. Let me tell you, this is your research work and you are talking about your research topic. So you need to talk very clearly and concisely about your research topic so that readers can easily understand the purpose of writing your research report and result which you have come up with by working hard into the lab. So in the next lecture, we'll talk in detail about the components and structure of a research report, and we'll elaborate each and every component and the details which needs to be there into the each section of research report. We'll also elaborate regarding the research article writing and the steps which are involved in research report writing. Thank you. Thank you very much.